Hello and welcome back to a new SkyT episode. Now, while I'm aware I keep taking like long breaks from doing this series, it's mostly because either something ends up breaking in one of my softwares and then finding the will to fix it takes a while, or just editing is just not a task my brain likes doing. So, it does take a while for me to make these episodes. I still want to try and finish these series because, well, it is actually kind of enjoyable doing YouTube. But anyway, now that that rant is over, we can finally get back to a new episode of SkyT. I am level 193, and it has been another long while since the last time, but yeah. Most of the softwares I used ended up having issues, such as OBS switched over to doing MK defaulting to MKV files, which made it harder to edit. Kden, I don't think there was an issue with Kden Live, the editing software I use. And then the software I used to make thumbnails, because I don't have Photoshop, is a software called Paint 3D, just the Microsoft one. Apparently, to get it to work again, to open files with the right-click menu. Or with the context menu, I think it's called. It ended up requiring me to call or ended up requiring me to install a older version of it, which I hope wasn't a virus. I don't think it was since I scanned it twice, but you never know. But anyway, we can now start this episode, and I do not remember pretty much any of my keybinds. Draconic B, Obsidian Nest. What did I need these for? Don't I need to do something in the end to actually get this to work? Yeah, so I need to feed this a treat in the end. That's how that works, right? Which means I would need to fight the Ender Dragon. And looking at my gear, well, maybe Netherite, it is completely unenchanted. Only 11 leather, so at least it's 11 more books, but that is still nowhere near the amount I was hoping for. So that's somewhat disappointing, but at least it is more books, so it's at least a couple more bookshelves. So with that, I should now be able to make an enchantment table. Enchant. Oh, forgot to unclick it. There we go. Enchantment table. Now I have that. Now I just need bookshelves. Once again, forgot to unclick it. All right, put those books in there and then craft as many as I can, which is only 7, but that will do. Since that at least lets me start enchanting. And then oh yeah, and then if I want to do that, I need even more books, so this is going to be a very costly process on the book side. And I guess until I get somewhere more set up for it, I guess here will do. What the heck is this? What was that? Yeah, I'm just gonna put music down to 0 if that was 7%. I have no idea what that Christmassy jingle was. Or like that upbeat music, whatever it was. So, yeah, I can just put these here. Then I need lapis and books because I want to get enough books to get like sharpness, whatever the maximum is in this pack. All right, put that away. I guess I'll put these bees in storage because I don't need them on me right now. Though I do still need the cages since the whole reason I'm doing all this was to try to get a draconic bee. Although I do not remember why I wanted one. I guess I will be finding out later. So, if I need books, I need leather, but the thing is, leather comes slowly, so. Since I don't have looting yet, so that means I have to see if there is a alternative, which is through canvas from Farmer's Delight, which I can grow out of straw or make it out of canvas rugs. Canvas rugs are made from canvas, so it doesn't matter. So straw, how does one get straw? By grind. Okay, so it's a byproduct of grinding or cutting. So I guess I need to get rice. Is that the only thing that grows it? It looks like I need to get rice, and then I can grind straw will be a byproduct that I can use to make books out of. Why isn't that placing in? What? The mark. Ooh, I can craft a market? I should probably do that. But yeah, looking at this, I can't actually. What? Press U here, crops. Yeah, it goes in. It looks like it goes into a botany pot and then that gives me rice panicles, but I can't put it in the botany pot. Is that not water? No, that's definitely water. That's definitely rice. It's just not growing. Let's see, is there a use for rice panicle in growing it? No, there isn't a use for rice panicle. Why can't I grow rice? Well then, I guess since rice growing does not work, if someone liked to tell me how to get that to work in the comments, that'd be nice. I guess I will be putting this back in here, and then I guess I will also put the rice back in storage, and then just farm a bunch of cows to get all the books I need. Which, do I have bone meal? Because I know that will speed up the process. I have 9 bone. Wait a minute. I have more than 9 bones. I have a malt farm. All right, so bone, I have a lot of bone. So just gonna fill my inventory up with this, and then I guess I will cut back in once I am done farming all of the ridiculous amount of leather this is going to take. And what bone was it to pause my recording? I have successfully replaced all the grass with cow. It's like a ball pit of cows. So I used up all the bone meal I had on the animal crop that was in here, wherever that was. I already lost it. Oh hey, free corner! Which means they were just choosing to make this harder when I was bone mealing the crop. But with all of these cows, hopefully I can get all the leather I need. It's like a cow liquid. Let's see. Yeah, they definitely aren't escaping, luckily. But at the same time, I don't think I'm escaping. I mean, this doesn't have the mod where I can like bounce off walls, right? Yeah, no, it doesn't. I don't think I have any method of flight yet. So yeah, I think I am just stuck here. Wait, wait. Idea. Of course I don't have one. Well, time to wait for all these cows to grow, I guess. Which is only gonna be like 1,000 seconds. That won't take
All
too
right,
long.
all
Now
right.
that took a while. But we got all the cows we needed and the liquid cow liquid or whatever is grown. So, time to start harvesting this. My cow liquid is contained in there and I managed to get out with a bunch of leather. I hopefully can enchant enough to get looting before I farm any more. And make the last bookshelves I need. All right, so store that, store that, store that, store that, store that. And I need to search. Book. All right, bookshelf or book. Do this. All right, that makes me about 90 books, and I should probably make the rest of the bookshelves I need before I go ahead and. Oh, that's cool. All right, so if I do this, oh, right off the bat, looting 3. Reaper? What is Reaper? Enchantment dot. Oh, okay, well, don't think I'm getting a description of what that does. Bane of arthropods. That's a bit unfortunate because it doesn't that mean I can't get the one I other one I want. Smite, loyalty. All right, go down here. And with that, the disenchantment extractor or the enchantment extractor, which judging by its name, it sounds like it can pull enchants off something. So if I can pull all these enchants off as separate books, I should then be able to reattach them as. Where can I put this? I'll put it up a floor. Can I put it up a floor? Yeah, I have to, that space. I guess I'll put it here for now. So I need books. That was kind of a given. Do I have more books? I have 14 more, of course. All right, and there we go. Put that here. And then put my sword, I think, there. Yep, that is slowly extracts all the enchants I want, which means it actually might be more effective, more of when it, actually is it more effective? I guess it could be more effective to enchant an item and then extract the books off of it. Because technically, then I only have to pay the XP once. So that actually seems more efficient. But with this, I can then take that Bane of Arthropods off and put on the sharpness I want and start working on making a bow to take to the nether or take to the end with me. I'm assuming I'm gonna need a lot of arrows and a ranged attack method. Luckily, arrows are something I have quite a lot of. And can I wonder if I can use these miniature red hearts, because if I remember correctly, these are from a mod that lets you increase your health bar. Wrong button. Meant to push that one. And I can store my arrows in here for the fight to make sure I have a lot of them. And then I guess I'll store some ender pearls because that sounds like they'd be valuable, right? I keep forgetting my backpack button. All right, and then miniature red hearts. What can I do with these? I can craft a heart amulet if I string glass. And if I can figure out how to get relic apples and canisters, I can make the red heart containers. And put a stack of bones in here. That will make a lot more canisters for my use. And with that, I should then be able to craft these, which, if I remember correctly, you only need 10. Which I have no idea if I'm remembering correctly. All right, and then oh yeah, for some reason this mod really hates glass, or I don't actually have any for some reason. Well, I guess I'll grab a few stacks of sand, make some glass, and then I can make the heart necklace I need. Which do I have furnace? No, furnaces are on the second floor. All right, so I can just throw this in here, this in here, this in here. But it's quite qu Minecraft's really quiet right now. Oh, hey, diamonds. Used to having at least like 7% music, but I don't want that weird jolly tune or whatever it is to just randomly appear again. No idea what it's even from. And yep, there we go. Already have almost a stack of glass, which is way more than I needed. This, I should be able to make the heart canister necklace. I just do this. Heart amulet. Right click to open, which I can then put these in. And if I wear this. Wait, why is it. Doesn't this. Wait, slot heart amulet. Where's the specific. Yep, there's a slot for it. That now gives me double the hearts. Now, what does it take to make the upgraded versions? Because if I can have multiple extra heart health bars before going to the, and going into the end, that'd be very helpful too. So let's see, heart. So pretty sure I can only have 10 of these, right? I'm gonna make one more just to make sure. And then if I take the necklace off. And then, yeah, I can't put that in. Okay, so I know for sure now. So, yellow heart containers. They're gotten from wither predictions. So I need to kill the wither for yellow hearts. Is that what it's saying? So just to make sure. Yeah, okay, so I can't progress any further unless I kill the wither. Which, with my sword now, it shouldn't be much more of a hassle, right? Okay, and for some reason it just works after ripping the book apart and then adding them separately. Okay, I do not understand enchanting rules at all. Well, I think this should be everything to at least go into a fight against the Wither for now. And then, if I can't fight the Wither, I guess I have no chance against the Ender Dragon. Which, I should probably bring a bunch of glass bottles for the Ender Dragon so I can get the Dragon's Breath. And then I need to bring an Overworld Cake so I can get back without actually having to kill the Dragon. And then, so I guess let's see if I can fight the Wither. See, 4 Soul Sand, 3 Wither Skulls. Alright, so I just put this here. And the Wither Skulls on top! Huh, no boss bar. That's weird. Okay, that Wither is doing a lot of damage. Okay, so I definitely can't survive the Wither yet. And looks like he's just gonna hang out up there. Am I actually... Is it actually safe to leave him in there? Good to know. I just gonna die, or... Oh wait, no, because every time I lose enough hearts, I just get auto-fed back up. So yeah, as long as I don't take more damage, I should survive. I guess I could technically just game it using the glass, but... Okay, so he can break the obsidian. Good to know, good to know. Where's its health bar anyway? Oh, got hit by the Wither again. Yeah, and I'm withered powder. Looks like this is dropping when the Wither breaks blocks. That's interesting. I mean, I guess this technically counts as a Wither fight, right? I mean, there is a Wither, and I am fighting it. I only don't get very much... Oh, it's below 100 health. Yay, I'm technically fighting the Wither. But yeah, I don't think this is going to fly against fighting an Ender Dragon. Might be able to live in the end for a little while. Oh yeah, I'm gonna have to farm a lot of these for the miniature yellow hearts, which... Oh yeah, I'm getting out of here too. So actually, I could just farm... Now that I have killed one, I can say that's legitimate enough for me to be willing to farm it. Since I don't remember exactly why I wanted to wait before. Until I've actually killed one to farm it. Let's see, wasn't this safe to... Oh. The lever. That should be safe, right? Yep, there we go. So yeah, now I can just construct withers to get rid of, to farm them for their yellow hearts. And then with that, I can get all the yellow hearts I need to gain an extra HP bar. And hit the lever preemptively, because that will make him spawn on the Mob Masher. Did I break the lever? The lever is on the other side of the wall now. Oh no, we're good. Yeah, with this I should be able to just keep assembling withers and killing them. Let's see, can I assemble multiple withers at the same time? Yep, multiple withers are allowed. Well, I guess I will just keep doing this until I have enough hearts and enough spare nether stars. Alright, I got all the yellow hearts I needed and 11 nether stars. So I should now be able to head back up. put these in here, and with the miniature yellow hearts, I should then be able to craft. Oh, these require red heart containers just to craft. Oh, so I'm gonna need to craft another 10 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then these, and then I need enchanted. I need gapples, which require a lot of gold. Do I have a lot of gold? I have a lot of gold. So much that it's lagging. It's just crafting more. It just queued them all up. Okay, that's interesting. Alright, then these can be, then I need to craft a bunch of these. And then with these, I should, put this here. Now I have over 10 of these. And then these require green hearts next, which are from the Ender Dragon. But now with yellow hearts, that's another health bar gained. So I think that should be enough for me to be able to survive in the end long enough to at least obtain the ability to get all the stuff I need from there. So I do have spare overworld cakes around here somewhere, right? Where are my overworld cakes? Do I not have any overworld cakes, or are they all in storage? I have 704 overworld cakes. I guess that answers my question. I'm only gonna take like 32 with me. No, I should probably leave them in my backpack in case I go somewhere and forget. Oh yeah, and I don't need all these arrows anymore because of the infinity. But what I'm gonna do with all the arrows I keep collecting, at least not until I get EMC. Once I can get EMC, then I know the exact purpose they're for. I only need to carry one arrow, so no point in holding a whole stack. So I got the BK. I was gonna use those obsidian nest in the end. Nest. Oh wait, are they in a room? Ah, oh, they're right here. Yeah, use it to attract on a bee, but I need to go to the end to use it to get the draconic bee I need. I still have no idea what the draconic bee is for. I do not remember at all what I wanted it for. But now I need honey treats. And I should probably carry a couple stacks and we need to get a few bees. And then let's see. So honey treats. And now I need bottles. Because I need to capture the dragon's breath. If this has botany, I need ender air. And that's all the bottles I have. So if I just do this. 48 more bottles. That should be enough, right? And now I should be able to head to the end. I should probably bring some blocks with me, huh? Alright, so that should just be enough blocks for anything I could ever imagine. Just bring a cobblestone gen with me. Alright, so I got food, got a few tools in here. I'm gonna put my other tools in here for now, so I don't have to have them on me. Alright, and then I don't really need my silk touch pickaxe. Actually, I probably will if I'm heading somewhere new. And then this should be everything I need. But since this video has been going on for 20 minutes longer than I had intended, I think next episode we'll be heading into the end, now that I spent this entire episode preparing for it. But anyway, I will probably be making the next episode a bit sooner than usual, because it's been a while since I last even made one of these episodes. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Next time we'll be heading to the end to get draconic bees, along with probably fighting the Ender Dragon. Probably. Well, I hope you enjoyed this episode. See you next time. Bye.